Our breaking news, a new account of Jamal Khashoggi's disappearance and presumed killing. Three sources familiar with the case say that it was intended to be a Saudi mission to interrogate and possibly abduct him, that something went wrong, he died, and it was poorly covered up. Now, earlier today, CBS News' Errol Barnett found himself on a flight with Jared Kushner, who reportedly has a close relationship with the Saudi crown prince, tried to ask him about Saudi royal family's denial of involvement in Khashoggi's disappearance, and that didn't go well. Those were Secret Service agents blocking Barnett's phone. People of the Washington Post want answers as well. It's where Jamal Khashoggi worked. Joining us for a reaction to the breaking news is his editor, Post Global Opinions editor, Karen Atiyah. Karen, does it make any sense to you, given all this new information, why the United States isn't taking any real action on this yet, or why the administration seems to be, at least publicly, buying Saudi Arabia's version of events here?
You know, all we can at least hope for and push for, you know, here at the Post, is that the administration take this seriously and that the administration pushed their Saudi counterparts, advised their Saudi counterparts to give us the truth and to give us the truth as quickly as possible.
In terms of the reporting that the Saudis suspected Khashoggi's having ties to Qatar and that may have been why they wanted to interrogate him, or at least in part, to your knowledge, did he have any ties with Qatar?
I mean, to my knowledge, I don't know about that. I think that ultimately still this is a case of a journalist who all he wanted to do was to write the truth as he saw it, who was who went into a Saudi consulate and never came back, regardless of views, regardless of ties. Anything that he wrote, at least with me at the Washington Post, was patriotic to Saudi Arabia. Was evoked a sense of wanting Saudi Arabia to be better, was a man who wanted to advise the young Saudi crown prince. He loved his country. And so, you know, reports of smearing him as some sort of traitor, I think, is grossly unfair and distracts from the question of what happened to him and what we're demanding from the Saudis as far as answers and truth.
And certainly just in terms of you know, what the Saudis have said and may say. I mean, there were, you know, we have this reporting from several sources that they may say that this was an interrogation gone bad. I mean, even if that becomes a story that they were trying to interrogate him and bring him back to Saudi Arabia, that in itself is just, I mean, even if it's true, it's just startling that they would be grabbing somebody who enters their consulate, interrogating that person with this plan, and then trying to bring them back to Saudi Arabia.
Right. I find this notion that is somehow more acceptable. I find it ridiculous and still, frankly, a bit disgusting. It's still kidnapping, and if we say interrogation, if the interrogation was so violent that it causes death, I mean, that sounds like torture, and that's still a flagrant violation of international law. And, you know, for, you know, an interrogation to have a team, to have a bone saw present during an interrogation, or to fly in a team with an autopsy forensics expert, you know, to me doesn't sound like a team that expected to bring back somebody alive. So, but regardless, I think a horrific crime happened to Jamal Khashoggi. And we need answers. We're fighting like hell here for answers.
Well, Karen, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you, Anderson.